Hey, thanks for playing the Microsoft Day of Data Treasure Hunt. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. In case you had any problems with any of these, I made a short video here showing you how I came up with each answer. Now, the great thing about Excel is there's five ways to do everything. There's a good chance that you might have found a different way to solve the problem. Let's get started. All right, our first question. How many space travelers have been on a mission that orbited the moon? With a hint there to be careful because Jim Lovell orbited the moon on two missions, but we're only counting him as one. Now, if you don't go to Excel, you're just gonna might think here, a well-known fact is 12 people have walked on the moon. So you might say that it's 12. But let's take a look at the data. So we come here to our workbook. We have five worksheets. I go to the crewed missions worksheet, and there is a column here for lunar orbit. So let's turn on the filters. This is on the data tab, turn on the filters. Lunar orbit, we want the lunar orbit equal to true, so I uncheck false. And when we scroll up, we see that these nine missions, Apollo 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17, have all gone around the moon. And if you know, the Apollo each had three people per mission, so 9 times 3, 27. Oh, no. That's where you might go wrong. All right, so let's come back here to mission by crew. Again, we'll turn on the filters here and under destination, and we'll choose just the moon. All right, and there are a list of the people. I select those people down here in the lower right-hand corner. We see that there's 27, but there are people that are in here twice, and you could just look at this, like there's Jim Lovell and Jim Lovell, but on the home tab, we go to conditional formatting, highlight cells, and ask for duplicate values. You'll see that Jim Lovell is there twice, Gene Cernan's there twice, John Young is there twice. All right, now there's actually two different ways that you could go here. One is a brand new function in Excel called the filter function. And because this is a cool function, let's talk about that. I'm gonna come out here and I'm gonna say equal filter. I wanna see from this data set, I wanna see all those names in column A, where the destination, that's in column H, so I choose the destination is equal to, in quotes, moon, close parenthesis, and that one formula will give me a list of all of the people who have gone to the moon. There's 27 people there. But I need to throw out the duplicates. I only want to keep one of Jim Lovell and John Young. So we're going to edit that formula and wrap the filter function in another new function called unique. All right, so the unique function. And that gives me the list of 24. How do I know there's 24? Ask for equal count A. That list, the hash there says, give me all of the results of that new dynamic array formula. And there's the 24. Probably the easier way to go though is to come here to the space traveler sheet where Microsoft has very nicely created a summary for us. And we'll turn the filters on again here. Now, if we would look for a walked on the moon greater than zero, that's where you'll see the 12 people who have walked on the moon. But that's not what we're looking for. We're looking for the people who left low Earth orbit. And I just want to call out here, this is really interesting to me. There are 570 rows, so that's 569 people minus the heading, who have left Earth on a mission. Out of those people, almost all of them have gone to what's known as low Earth orbit for a space station. That might be anywhere from 60 to 250 miles above the Earth. The moon, though, that's 240,000 miles above the Earth. So out of these 500 people, the ones we're really interested in are the people who have left low Earth orbit. And right there, that's the list of the 24 people. Only 24 have gone more than 250 miles above the Earth. And right now, the only place where they've gone is the moon. Someday, that may be Mars or an asteroid. But right now, these 24 people are the 24 people who have gotten to within 60 to 70 miles of the moon. Very special, special list of people there who have gone further than anyone else. All right, so the answer to question number one is 24. All right, question number two. Who had the most hours of spacewalk activity? So this is, you're in your spacecraft, you put on the EVA suit, EVA is extravehicular activity, you go into the airlock and they open the door and now you're outside. All right, this is fascinating. On our workbook here, there's a list of all of the spacewalks, 829 of those. Come on here to Space Travelers, where there is an awesome thing called EVA duration in hours. Man, it seems simple. Just sort this descending and Anatoly Soloviev with 78.8 hours. Answer to question two is B. All right, question three. Which space traveler has launched the most number of times? For me, launch is the most exciting part. There's all the fire and rumble, and we live here in Florida, about 12 miles from where the rockets launch. It shakes the house, right, 12 miles away. So we're trying to figure out who has launched the most number of times. The easiest way to get this is to come back here to the Space Travelers Worksheet, and we have a mission count column. I want to know who had the most number of missions. So very easy, just choose one cell in column F, and on the data tab, click Z to A, like that. All right, Al, we've had two people to tie with seven missions each. Jerry L. Ross and Franklin Chang Diaz have seven. Beyond that, there is a big tie for second place with a lot of people with six. All right, so easy one here. Jerry L. Ross and Franklin Chang Diaz. Answer D for question three. Question four. Who is the woman with the most days in space? And, you know, I added this question because I think it's important to understand. A lot of people know about these guys, the Mercury 7, the first seven astronauts, but people don't realize that at the same time of the Mercury 7, there were 13 women who were trained for the Mercury program, but the U.S. Congress said, no, there's no way they're flying. These ladies, not as well known as the original Mercury 7, but still frequent visitors back here to the space coast. Now, the first woman in space was Valentina Tereshkova. That was in 1963 in the Russian space program. But let's figure out who has spent the most time in space. So we have our space travelers here. I will add the filter in and go to the gender column and choose only female. All right, so there's a list of all of the female astronauts and cosmonauts have flown, and then here, mission time in column G, I'll choose one cell and click Z to A, and there we are. And there we are, Peggy Whitson with 665.94 days in space. So question four, the answer is B, Peggy Whitson. All right, question number five, how many people launched on a space shuttle but then returned on a Soyuz spacecraft? That means you left from Florida and you land in Russia. All right, so to do this, let's come back to mission by crew. And there's a nice column here, column D, changed craft. We'll turn on the filters and filter to changed craft equals true. And there are a lot, actually, I was surprised. A total of 133 times that someone flew up on one spacecraft and flew back on another. Although, you'll see here, they flew up on Discovery and came back on Discovery, but it was a different flight of Discovery. So we want to look for something a little bit more interesting than that. I want to know who left Earth on the space shuttle. So here in column B, we're going to search for STS. That stands for Space Transport System. That's the abbreviation for the space shuttle. Click OK and we get all of the STS flights, all the space shuttle flights. And then for the return, we'll search for Soyuz and click OK. Scroll up, and there we are. There's five. Five is the correct answer. Of course, it would be just as interesting to find the opposite. So we'll clear that. We'll look for someone who returned on STS and launched on Soyuz. And there it is, six. So five that launched on the shuttle and came back on Soyuz, six who launched on Soyuz and came back on the shuttle, but the way the question is worded, how many launched on the shuttle and returned on Soyuz? So it is five. Answer C. All right, there you have it. I hope you had fun playing. Check out that data set, all kinds of fun things you can discover about all the astronauts and spacewalks and rockets that we're using to go to space. I want to thank you for playing. This is Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com.